Hello everyone.
Myself Arijit Mitra, faculty adjunct Kolkata, and today I will be your facilitator for the session. Before we start with our session, I request all of you to take your memory back to your training session or training time and try to recollect what exactly you did in your two major departments of kitchen. One is butchery and other one is garmenter. Our topic for the day is totally related with these two departments and its different functions and other areas. Let us see the different scopes that we have in this particular topic. In this entire topic, we are going to cover definition of larder, followed by the hierarchy of larder department, duties and responsibilities of larder chef, and commonly used larder terms. In this presentation, we are going to discuss very important and few larder terms, and rest all will be there in the handout. The learning outcomes, definitely at the end of the session, what will be the learning outcomes and objectives? So by the end of the session, you will be able to define the term larder and its importance in kitchen division. You will be able to describe the hierarchy of the department and different duties and responsibilities of larder chef. As per the mindset is concerned, you will appreciate the importance of larder kitchen and its different functions. In the commercial kitchen, larder kitchen refers to garmenter. Now here, if you remember, in your training time, I strongly believe that you never saw a department specifically called larder. Rather, you saw the department garmenter, where different types of salads, different types of dressings, cold cuts prepared and kept ready for buffet presentation. So, in five-star hotel, larder is very commonly termed as garment. Larder, this particular term is derived from the word larder, cut. Derived from the word lard, and technically lard means pork fat. At that point of time, when refrigeration system was not available, in butchery section specifically, pork and pork products were hugely used, and that's why the pork fat or lard was easily available. And that particular fat is used in different types of food preparations. Though larder were considered as a cold place to store different foodstuffs, whether it is perishable or not perishable. So basically, larder is a place where we store cheese, vegetable, and different meat products. The kitchen, as far as its functions are concerned, prepare different types of sausages, force meat, pate and terrine. This pate and terrine are a part of force meat where a good amount of lard or pork fat is used. As we know, larder is a storeroom. So initially larder is divided into two major divisions. First one, wet larder, and the second one is dry larder. Wet larder is a place where normally meat products are kept ready for further use, that means for further cooking, and also game birds, seafood items are prepared and kept ready for further use. On the other hand, in the dry larder section, all types of cheese, especially the hard cream cheese, different types of dry fruits, different types of pulses and grains are stored. So it is not only the place where foods are only kept ready for further use, it is also the place where exactly different types of foods are prepared and served to different parts of kitchen, especially for a la carte and for buffet presentation. Our ancestors, they not only masters the art of farming, but also they masters the job of preserving the food for long period of time. This particular department also prepared different types of starters, which are commonly known as odofu. Can you identify this picture? Okay. We'll discuss it just after this. This is just for information. It's a nice art of Ghat Manjar, and this picture is basically a picture of a butter sculpture. This is ideally a larder kitchen, which is located near to the main kitchen, and you can see different types of chopping boards are visible. Few machineries are visible, which are a very important part of larder section. And this nice and beautiful picture is the picture of different coal cuts, which are prepared, arranged, and kept ready for buffet service. So let us see what is the important and functions of larder in terms of these pictures. Larder kitchen also specializes in preparing decorative items. So that means it's a department where not only salads, salad dressings, sandwiches, cold cuts are prepared, but this is also a department where different types of carvings are prepared. Vegetable carving, fruit carvings, butter sculpture, and these are prepared and kept ready for decorative purpose in different buffet counters. Ideally, the larder kitchen must be located in a cool place. Normally in a 5-star hotel, the larder kitchen located along with the main kitchen, but ideally it should be separated from the main kitchen, because this particular department deals with lot of raw food items, and where the chances of cross contamination is very high. Again, if we talk about the operation part of larder, whatever items and foodstuffs prepared within this department, these are specifically prepared for major two operations. One is for a la carte and one is for buffet. So let us continue with the definition part. Whatever we have discussed so far, if we club all the points together, the definition of larder will become in this way. It is the coal kitchen, which we have discussed, where all the foodstuffs are prepared and kept ready for further use, that means for further cooking. Used for the storage and preparation of perishable foods, both raw and cooked. So in this particular department, raw food items like meat items, seafoods are fabricated and kept ready for further use. And on the other hand, cooked food items like different sauces like mayonnaise, different types of dressings are prepared and kept ready for further use. Especially all types of meat, fish and vegetables and other perishable products are kept ready for cooking, which we have discussed earlier. All the varieties of salads, cold appetizers, this particular term in French known as podof. Cold sauce and dressings are made ready for further use. Different types of cold buffet items are prepared. In the last slide also, we saw the beautiful pictures of the cold cuts, which is prepared and kept ready for buffet presentation. Apart from this, we'll be moving to the next slide, where we have hierarchy of the department. So far we have discussed the different features and different functions of larder in introduction part. We have discussed the definition in detail, and now we are into hierarchy of the larder department. Larder department is one of the important and major department as kitchen operations are concerned in any 5-star, 3-star or 2-star hotel. The hierarchy depends how many rooms you are operating, how many restaurants you are operating, and how many buffets you have. Depending on that, the department fix the number of staff which will be required for the smooth operation of the department. But as a whole, if we talk about in general, the department in charge is known as larder chef, and in very common terms nowadays in 5-star hotel, they also called as chef de garde. He is wholesale responsible for the department's function, and he or she directly reports to executive chef. Whenever the larder chef is in off or not in the hotel, the next person The kitchen executive is in charge. That means position wise is just after larder chef, and also equally responsible for the smooth function of the department. Now, as we have discussed earlier, that this particular department deals with lot many cold items preparation like salads, sandwiches, sauces, cold cuts, carvings. Thus, the departments also subdivided into different subcategories or subsections. These particular sections also technically termed as breakdown of larder block. And as you know, the entire department is subdivided into different sections. In each section also, we have got departmental or section heads, which are very commonly termed as chef department, which you have learned in your semester 1, the position of different kitchen staffs in kitchen operation. So each CDP or chef department is responsible for each section. Like in the presentation, we have got odof section or starter section, we have got shakutiyak, we have got butchery, we have got sauce section. So like that, depending on the operation, it can be subdivided into many other sections, and ideally each section should be having one section in charge or CDP. Just after CDP, it is COMI. Again, depending on the operation, there will be COMI 1, COMI 2 and COMI 3, and they are actually responsible for food preparation, fabrication, keeping the a la carte food ready, keeping the buffet food ready. So they are actually those staffs who work in the range and as well as prepare the food for smooth functioning of the department. So just after COMIs, the next position we have in the kitchen, apprentice, and after apprentice, the position of trainee staff. So that's why in the beginning I told you, try to recollect your training time, and now in the entire brigade, we are there to learn things, what is happening inside the kitchen. So that is the objective of us. And that's why you can understand why your position is very important as far as to know the functions of kitchen operations are concerned. After hierarchy, we are going to discuss the duties and responsibilities of larder chef. Just in the previous slide, we have discussed in a nutshell what are the duties and responsibilities of larder chef. Now here, in this slide, we will discuss in detail. The first important duty and responsibility of larder chef is coordination. So as you know, the entire kitchen operation, not only kitchen, FAP service, housekeeping, front office, these four major departments, they work together to ensure that at the end of the day, everything goes very smoothly. Starting from checking of the guest, and once the guest is in the room, starting from room service, once the guest is in the restaurant or in the buffet, and once the guest is going out. So almost we need a very in-depth coordination among all the four departments to ensure everything goes very smoothly. It is also followed in the kitchen itself, where larder need to maintain a very good and strong co-coordination along with other departments. Other departments in terms of hot kitchen, bakery and other parts of or other sections of kitchen. For example, we can say, as you know, in the larder department, one of the major item is or section is salad. For example, we can say, in a day's work, the chef wants to prepare a salad made out of vegetables like salade russe or Russian salad in common terms. There, we need different types of colorful and assorted vegetables like carrots, potato, French beans, green peas, etc. Before we dress the salad, those items need to be blanched. And after blanching, that is dressed with mayonnaise sauce and served. So regarding this blanching of vegetables, the chef need to go out of the kitchen as because it's a cold kitchen, and they need to move to the hot kitchen to blanch the vegetables and get the job done. So regarding this particular task, larder need to have very good coordination with hot section of kitchen. Another example which is very very important and very common, like in this particular department larder, we prepare different types of cold sandwiches. Now regarding sandwiches, as you know, the major ingredient or part is bread. So regarding this particular item, bread, lard are need to coordinate always with bakery. Why so? Because ideally the bread that you are using for making sandwich need to be 1 day old, so that you can cut the sides of the breads well. So regarding that, we need to have a very good coordination with bakery. So 1 day before, my stock need to be there in my kitchen. On the other hand, in the larder section, different types of appetizers and starters are served. Like if I want to serve something in pastry shell, that I have to order to bakery, and I have to ensure as a chef that before service or before preparation, that is kept ready in my section. So like that, there are n number of examples we have, but we need to have very good and very strong coordination with other departments in terms of kitchen planning and operations. Training and development of staffs, very important function and duty and responsibility of larder chef. Training of departmental staff. Now, why we need to conduct training? Why we need to have training session every day? It's not only helps us to upgrade our knowledge, but also it also helps us to know what are the new trends in the kitchen and how we can deliver that to the guest. Regarding that, different types of training can be conducted, or larder chef need to ensure that different training sessions are conducted to ensure staffs are well aware of the operations. For example, we can say if the larder chef is demonstrating some items, showing the staff, that means to kitchen executives, to commis, to apprentices, how this particular salad will be prepared, how it will be dressed, how it will be presented to the customers, to the guest, then they will set the standard, and depending on the laid down standard, they will prepare the salad and serve it to the guest. Staff scheduling and duty roster, one of the challenging part of larder chef, because all the staffs are very close to their heart, but they need to consider all the factors, and finally they need to prepare the staff scheduling and duty roster in such a way that in this operation everything goes very smoothly. In all departments, the presence of staff need to be there. They need to coordinate, they need to understand, talk to each other to ensure everything goes very smoothly. So keeping all the factors in mind, larder chef need to prepare the duty roster. Food preparation, though larder chef is not very much or directly involved in food preparation, but yes, of course, as you know, the department, as a department in charge, he or she is definitely responsible for food preparation, but it only happens when you have new items to be introduced to your kitchen and need to have trial in the kitchen. Go for trials for a particular item, and then finally one time will come, you fix that dish, and then that dish is standardized and served to the guest. So regarding those times, those issues in the kitchen, larder chef is responsible for food preparation, and as well as also responsible to demonstrate that in the staff. Storage, as we have discussed, larder is the only department in kitchen where everything is stored in terms of wet larder, in terms of dry larder. All the expensive items you name in kitchen, like you talk about international sausages, salamis, different types of ready to use meat products, different types of hard cheese, soft cheese, semi hard cheese, everything, all the expensive items are stored in larder section. And that's why it is very important that all the items, whatever is there inside the kitchen, would be kept under lock and key. And as a chef, they need to ensure that while issuing the items from the larder kitchen or larder department, the LIFO and FIFO, these two particular methods need to be followed very strictly. Here we have two terms, one is LIFO and one is FIFO. LIFO stands for last in, first out, and FIFO stands for first in, first out. The next duty and responsibility of larder chef is menu planning. Once we talk about menu planning, in the initial stage, larder chef is responsible for menu planning. Later on, as he is directly reports to the executive chef, he along with the executive chef, along with all other chef, they sit together and discuss about the new menu or upcoming menu. Then there are different steps need to be followed to ensure that menu is ready to serve to guests. Security, it is very much related with storage only. As a chef, it is not only duty and responsibility of larder chef or the kitchen executive, but whoever is responsible within that department, all of them are equally responsible for the security, safety and security of the department. All the expensive items need to be kept under lock and key. Whenever any item issued to any other department, the stock register need to be maintained. After security, we have got stock checking. This is one of the major duty and responsibility of larder chef, where on daily basis he or she checks the stock. Now there are certain tags, the sheets, the registers that is followed and maintained within the department to ensure that at the end of the day, the stock taking process complete perfectly, so that next day the indenting can be done properly for other operations. For example, we can say in a particular day's work, after operations, if I have 5 kg of chicken left in my kitchen, and the next day in the buffet I have 15 kg of chicken need to be used for a particular dish or preparation, and as per standard I have 2 kg of chicken need to be kept as a bar stock, then keeping all these factors in mind, I have to indent for the next day's operation, where I have to issue 15 kg of chicken to banquet kitchen. I need to have 2 kg of chicken bar stock in my hand, and at the end of the day I have got 5 kg of chicken left to us. Like that, in that registers, all the items, whatever used within the kitchen or within the sections, are kept ready and ensure that stock checking process taken perfectly to ensure next day indenting is done properly as per the need of other kitchen sections. We move to the next slide, where we have some important larder terms. As I mentioned earlier, that important larder terms here, whatever we have, we are going to discuss, and later on in the word format of the notes, we have other technical terms, or rather that number go on and on. We, as you know that in kitchen there is no end of anything, it's like an ocean, but we will try to focus the important terms which frequently comes in exam, and these are the terms which frequently used inside the kitchen. First one, antipasti. Now before we move into this term, one thing just want to share with all of you, that larder section, one of the important subsection is appetizer. Now worldwide, we observe the different appetizers are served throughout the world. In different countries, in different cuisines, appetizers are termed in different ways. Antipasti, in that way, is a particular term or technical term used in Italian cuisine, which only indicates to Italian appetizers or starter. So there are different types of antipasti which are served in the Italian cuisine, and these are very world famous, but antipasti technically is the term used for Italian appetizers. Aspic, one of the important term and ingredient used inside the larder kitchen, and this particular product used in cold section, or where all types of cold cuts are prepared. It is basically a reduced gelatinized stock used to coat cold cuts. So you keep on reducing the stock with various items, and then at one point will come, the stock will become very gelatinized and crystal clear. Then that stock is reduced, it is strained and used to coat cold cuts to prevent the cold cuts to get dry in the buffet counter. Canapé, very important technical term. This particular term, canapé, or this particular product is prepared in appetizer section. These are very small pieces of fancy fancy breads with a topping, and then it is always serves as an appetizer, and it comes under cold category or cold variety. Curing is a term used for treating the meat with salt to preserve the meat for long period of time. Galantine, again this particular term or product used in cold cut section, where it indicates the whole chicken or whole bird along with the skin. It is deboned, stuffed with a mincemeat mixture, lots of nuts, dry fruits. Then it is rolled into a cylindrical shape. It is poached in a poaching liquor. Then it is sliced into thin slices and always served in the cold buffet counter with a coating of aspic. Next we have Kadbanjan. As you know, it's a common term for larder, and where in French term for larder kitchen, which means keeping cold to eat later. So basically Kadbanjan is nothing but another name of larder. Lard, if you remember in the opening slide itself, I told you larder came from the word lard, where exactly lard means pork fat, and this pork fat is one of the key ingredient which is used almost in every cold cut preparation, whether it is pate, whether it is terrine, whether it is galantine, mousse, mousseline, everywhere pork fat is very much used. Odof is a very common term for appetizers in French. Mezze, as I mentioned before, appetizers are available worldwide, but only cuisine-wise, country-wise, the name changes. So mezze is a technical term for appetizer or appetizers from Middle East or Middle East cuisine. Tapas is a term used for Spanish appetizers, where in the buffet different types of pickled items, fruits, nuts are kept as part of appetizer. Next, chinois is a conical strainer which is free in shape and used to strain the soups and different types of sauces where particles need to be removed. So at the end we will summarize the entire topic, and whatever we have discussed from the features of larder, from the introduction of larder department, from the definition part, from the hierarchy, from duties and responsibilities of the chef, if we can club all the points together. In the hotel industry, larder kitchen refers to a separate department that is associated with cold food preparation. So if you move to a 5-star hotel or 4-star or 3-star, there is a presence of larder section or Kadbanjan section. Depending on the work, depending on the number of rooms, depending on the restaurants, the operation may be small or big, but there is a presence of larder section in almost all the hotels. This particular kitchen department specializes in making cold salads, appetizers, soups and other specific tasks like cold meat platters and carving. Apart from that, they are also responsible to serve for both operations, a la carte and for buffet. The department in charge is known as larder chef, which we have discussed. Larder chef is also very commonly known as chef de Kadbanjan, and he or she is totally responsible for entire operation of the department. At the end, we have some concept review questions, and these questions frequently comes in your exam. So what I request to all of you, that you must practice these questions in your home, in a A4 size paper or in a copy. You note down all the important points, go through the notes, PowerPoint presentation, and then try to answer all these questions by your own. The first one is, what is your understanding about the term Kadbanjan? Discuss the various duties and responsibilities of larder chef. In detail, we have discussed all this in our PPT presentation. With the help of a neat flowchart, analyze the departmental structure of a larder kitchen. So in this particular question, you need to draw the picture of departmental structure rather of a larder section, and then you try to identify each task of each and every individual chef's of the department, and then you keep on analyze the answer like that till the end. Thank you very much. Hope you enjoyed the session very well. Stay safe along with your family in this pandemic with situation raised by COVID-19. Thank you very much again. Hope you have enjoyed the session.